Two fractions have a sum of 1/4. The denominators of the fractions are different. Complete the fraction equation. So we're looking for two fractions that have a sum of 1/4, but the two fractions have different denominators. To help us answer this question, let's model the fraction of 1/4 using this rectangle as one whole. So because the denominator is 4, we will cut our partition, the rectangle, into 4 equal pieces. Let's say here, here, and here. And because the numerator is 1, or because our fraction is 1/4, we will shade one of the 4 pieces to model 1/4. And now to find two fractions that have a sum of 1/4, we will cut our partition, the rectangle, into additional pieces of the same size, let's say here. Now because the rectangle is cut or partitioned into 8 equal pieces, each piece would be 1/8. So from this model, we should recognize that 1/8 plus 1/8 is equal to 1/4. But our fractions must have different denominators, so we can't use this equation, but we can use one of the fractions. Let's go ahead and use the fraction of 1/8 here, and we'll go ahead and assume the 1/8 that we're referring to is this piece here. So if we can find a fraction to model this piece using a different denominator, we can complete our equation. To do this, we just need to cut our partition, the rectangle, into additional pieces of the same size. Let's say we now cut our partition, the rectangle, here and here. Notice now we have the rectangle cut or partitioned into 16 pieces of the same size, so each piece would be 1/16, which means these two pieces would represent the fraction 1/2/16. So now we know that 1/8 plus 2/16 equals 1/4. Again, the fraction of 2/16 represents these two pieces in the rectangle. So 1/8 plus 2/16 does equal to 1/4. And just to check, this piece here was 1/8. Each of these two pieces is 1/16. And we can see that the sum of these fractions is 1/4 of the whole. Let's take a look at a second example. This is the same type of problem, but now we have two fractions that have a sum of 2/3, and again, the denominators of the fractions are different. We want to complete the fraction equation. So let's begin by modeling the fraction of 2/3, where this rectangle represents one whole. So because the denominator is 3, we will cut or partition the rectangle into 3 equal pieces, let's say here and here. And because the numerator is 2, or because the fraction is 2/3, we will shade 2 of the 3 pieces to model 2/3. And now to help us write our equation, we will cut or partition the rectangle into additional pieces of the same size, let's say here. Notice now the rectangle is cut or partitioned into 6 pieces of the same size, so each piece would be 1/6. So from here, we should be able to recognize that we could write the equation 2/6 plus 2/6 equals 2/3. But we cannot use this equation because we need two fractions with different denominators, but we can use one of the fractions. Let's use the fraction of 2/6 here. And we'll go ahead and assume the 2/6 we're referring to would be these two pieces here. Which means now if we can find a fraction with a different denominator to represent these two pieces, we can complete the equation. And we can do this if we cut or partition the rectangle into additional pieces of the same size. Let's say we cut or partition the rectangle here, here, and here. Now the rectangle is cut or partitioned into 12 pieces of the same size, so each piece would be 1/12. So we could use the fraction of 1/2/3/4/12 to model these 4 pieces. So now we know that 2/6 plus 4/12 equals 2/3. Again, the 4/12 is modeled by these 4 pieces. So again, one possible equation would be 2/6 plus 4/12 equals 2/3. To verify this, we know this shaded region here does represent 2/3, and here's 1/6, and here's another 6, so there's the 2/6, and then we have 1/12, 1/12, 1/12, and 1/12, giving us 4/12. So notice how the sum of all these pieces is equal to 2/3. Or if we want, we can outline this in yellow. So here's one whole, and now it's divided into thirds. So here's the 2/6 plus 4/12 does give us 2/3 of one whole. I hope you found this helpful.